This video is recommended for those architects who are already familiar with ARCHICAD and have some knowledge of Grasshopper as well. This tutorial provides a basic introduction to the features and functionality provided by the Grasshopper Live Connection Tool. Please visit graphisoft.com/rhino-grasshopper for further information and to download and install the free plugins. Before starting with Grasshopper, let's review and understand the rules we would like to apply when creating the algorithmic fence. We'll start by creating a path in Grasshopper, which will define the floor plan geometry path of the fence. This is the blue line. Next, we'll define the positions on the path where we would like to add vertical fence posts. These positions are marked in purple on the sketch. We also want to define the height of the individual posts. We would like to create a fence that has a wave-like elevation, represented by the green lines. The wave-like shape will be ensured by the height difference of the posts. We will use the column element to create the vertical posts of the fence. Columns are native ARCHICAD BIM elements, and now, thanks to the new Grasshopper Live Connection tool, such elements can be created through Grasshopper as well. The column component in Grasshopper has four input parameters. We will use only two input parameters in this example, the anchor point and the end point input parameters. We will use the anchor point input parameter to define the positions of the columns, represented by the purple marks on the sketch. The end point input parameter will define the height of the column, represented by the green lines on the sketch. Let's open Rhino, Grasshopper, and ARCHICAD now. We need to install these applications on the same computer, as well as the Grasshopper Live Connection tool. First, let's start the Live Connection in ARCHICAD. The Grasshopper palette can be displayed using the Design, Design Extras, Grasshopper Connection command. Let's click the Start Connection button here to initiate the live connection between the applications. Next, we'll create a spline element in ARCHICAD using the Spline tool in the toolbox. This will represent the path of the fence, represented by the blue line in the sketch drawing. Let's display the ARCHICAD tab page in Grasshopper and select the Spline parameter node on the Grasshopper canvas. We will use this parameter node to create a referenced connection with the ARCHICAD spline element. All we need to do is to right-click the Spline Parameter node in Grasshopper and choose the Set One Spline in ARCHICAD option from the context menu. Please note that after initiating this command, only the ARCHICAD application will be displayed on the screen, because now we must select a spline element in ARCHICAD in order to proceed. After selecting the spline in ARCHICAD, both Rhino and Grasshopper are displayed again on the screen. Please note that the spline is now visible in Rhino as well. This signifies that we've successfully established the connection between the Grasshopper spline parameter node and the ARCHICAD spline element. Let's return to Grasshopper and add the Divide Curve component to the project. We can do this by right-clicking the canvas and begin typing Divide into the text entry field to filter the available options. We'll use this component to generate the positions of the posts on the spline, represented by the purple marks in the sketch. We will connect the output node of the spline parameter component to the curve input node of the divide curve component. Let's add a number slider to the canvas from the parameters tab page in Grasshopper. We'll use this to define the number of the division points on the spline, that is, the number of fence posts on the spline. We can enter a custom name for the slider, which will make it easier to remember later on. Let's define integer numeric values, represented by the capital letter N. We may also define minimum and maximum values as well as increments for the number of the columns. Please note that the 3D window of Rhino provides instant visual feedback on the number of division points on the spline when we modify the number slider in Grasshopper. This affects the density of the posts in the fence. Let's continue and add the column component to the Grasshopper canvas from the ARCHICAD tab page. This component requires only one obligatory parameter input, that is, the anchor point. We'll connect the points output of the division curve component, with the anchor point input of the column component. Please note that the ARCHICAD columns are not only instantly visible in ARCHICAD, but also in Rhino as well. Thanks to the Live Connection tool, there is no need to export and import files. The three applications create a unique design environment. The columns are created using their default height value, as is visible in the Column Default Settings dialog in ARCHICAD. We have the ability to control the height of the columns in Grasshopper. Let's add the Move component to the canvas. We'll use this component to specify the height for the points located on the spline created earlier. Let's also add the Unit Z component to define the vertical direction when moving the endpoints. The distance of the move will be defined by a new number slider. This will define the height of the columns. Please note that the duplicated endpoints are visible in the 3D window of Rhino. We can use the number slider to adjust their elevation. As a result, we're now able to modify the height of the columns, but we can define only uniform height. The next step is to make it possible to create variable column heights. We would like to design a wavy fence. Let's return to sketching once again. The sine function creates a wavy curve that we can also benefit from when adjusting the heights of the posts in our fence. Here's the sketch of a sine curve. First, we will identify values along the horizontal x-axis of the coordinate system. Then we will find the y-values corresponding to these x-coordinates along the sine curve. So first, we'll generate a coordinate sequence along the x-axis, and then we'll use the corresponding y-values to modify the uniform height of the columns. Part of these distance values along the y-axis will be positive. Part of these will be negative values. We'll add these y-coordinate values to the height of our columns to achieve a wavy fence. As a result, some of the column posts in the fencing are going to be higher, while others will be shorter, according to the sine function. Let's see how to implement the above steps in Grasshopper. First, we will add a sine function to the canvas. We will also add a series component to generate those coordinates along the x-axis. We want to generate as many x-values as column posts, so we can simply connect the existing number of columns slider to the count input of the series component. We will use another number slider to define the distance between the previously created x coordinates. This will define the exact shape of the wave. Let's add a panel to the canvas to make sure that the coordinate results are appropriate. As you can see, the generated numbers are appropriate. Part of these are positive, others are negative, as defined by the sine function. Now we will add these generated values to the default height of the columns and create the wavy fence. All we need to do is to feed the new values to the Unit Z component, and the wavy fence is instantly visible in ARCHICAD. We may use the distance between x-coordinate slider to modify the shape of the wave. Let's continue the design and specify slender posts having circular cross-sections. We'll start by adding the column settings component to the Grasshopper canvas. We will select the circular option for the structure of the ARCHICAD columns using the context menu of this component. We will add another number slider to define the diameter of the circular cross-section of the posts. As soon as we connect the new component to the column settings input node in Grasshopper, the ARCHICAD 3D view immediately reflects the changes. The columns become slender and circular. We can further adjust the characteristics of the sine wave at any time using the distance between x-coordinates number slider in Grasshopper. For the last steps, let's check out how to modify the footprint or floor plan geometry of the fence in ARCHICAD. Please remember that we started the design in ARCHICAD by creating a spline that we later referenced from Grasshopper. If we select the initial spline component on the Grasshopper canvas, the ARCHICAD spline element is also selected. Let's now modify the geometry of the spline in ARCHICAD. In order to update the design, please don't forget to press the Send Changes button on the Grasshopper palette. This button signals Grasshopper to update the project, and the updated fence geometry is instantly visible in the Rhino 3D view, as well as in the ARCHICAD 3D window. Please remember, the Rhino, Grasshopper, and ARCHICAD Live Connection Tool offers a seamless bi-directional geometry transfer, as well as a way to translate basic geometrical shapes into full BIM elements while adding algorithmic editing functionality.